about your grandfather. You said he was a hero.
One time we walk in the company from the meet. It was a small company. And he take me up and he put me on some pallets. And say, I want that you make my company one of the biggest of Belgium. And I never forget that. And I did it for him.
Motivated you.
I motivated always.
You saw him
always. I promised him and I do it for him. And always think on that side. Always. But that's the reason he is my hero. He is always with me. Charles de Kock, that's his name. Yeah. Downstairs here is the place for the breeders. All the breeders are downstairs. Upstairs are the old birds and yearling birds, and on the other side, upstairs, are the young birds. This is now, everything is cleaned for winter time. Everything is ready for start to breeding now. You see the lofts are very clean, like new. Every year we do that. Well, we can put this open. We have screens in the summer. It's always the screens are open. It's like a volière in the summer.
How many birds do you have in the apiary?
In the breeding of around 30 breeding pairs. I have 60 breeding pairs. They are only our voedsters. Feeding the youngsters. In the front are the good breeding pairs, and in the back are the feeders. And I always replacement the eggs on the backside.
How many eggs can you get per pair?
I have one hen lay 5 times, maybe 6 times in a year. Not more. But I have a cock. I have maybe 30 cocks, but I have 60, 70 hens. And always I change the hens with the cocks. And the cocks in the front have never youngsters. They are always on the backside. These are separate boxes here, only for one pair always. Then we are very sure it's from that cock. And here always we have 8 different boxes for the best breeding cocks. So here the breeding hens are today coming downstairs. I have put them for a few months upstairs and we clean everything. The first day they are here now. In 6 weeks we start the breeding, but now they are here. That are the breeding hens. They have a special place here that they cannot have make a pairing. And then they cannot have eggs. Herbazim, very nice product. The tea, herba tea.
Yes.
Great, the food is everything. It's from Beiers. Yeah, that's het eten dat we geven van Beiers in de Rijmengen. That is the feeding when we give for the molting time on the pigeons. I always, my basic is long distance of Beiers. That's my basic feeding, only that. And then I do their super diet or zuivering. I make a mix of that. But the basic is always long distance, always.
Super diet or diet speciaal?
Both, I mix.
23, 24.
I mix it, Yes? Yeah, now we're gonna put them here in the sauna.
They took a bath and here they dry?
They dry in the sauna, yes. And now we're gonna bring another part to take a bath there, the other one in the sauna. We can just make a turn. They are usual to do that, eh? Yeah, you know the way. Eh? The first time with young birds, eh? it's always easy. And now we're gonna put the verneveling on. Dat werkt niet, of wat?
Nee, dat werkt niet.
So okay. Do you also do this in the summertime?
Yeah, always. In the summertime, the day of basketing, no, basketing day, they don't go not outside, they only go in the bed and in the sauna. And then in the evening we do the basketing.
And you notice it on the feathers?
On the feathers, and always when the pigeons go not in the bed, there is a problem. Yeah. On the head, most likely. Yeah, the day from basketing, always, we don't let the pigeons go out for training. We keep them inside. We put them in the bath, and after we put them in the sauna. For us, it's a big sign to see the condition. The pigeons go very quickly in the water, or not very quickly. Or sometimes go not in the water, then there's something wrong with the pigeons. Yeah.
So it's
the
water
is cold?
No, it's...
Temperized.
Yeah, temperized, yeah. Yeah, normal, not hot, but...
Here, what's the temperature? Here, what's the temperature? Not the infrared.
Like infrared sauna.
Yeah, like sauna, you can feel it.
It
feels nice, when you're still here. Feel?
If you want that, take your chair,
You can sleep here,
You only have to pay the...
tomorrow.
This site is for the witwers and the witwer hens. Now they are all empty, but we start for cleaning in winter time. You can see everything, it's empty. There's still dirt, this one.
This is the racing loft.
The racing loft. This site is mostly for the hens, and this site is for the cocks. Yeah. And they are always coming on this side inside. We have three places to come inside. This here we have screens, and here we have docketing system automatic. And we can put it with the clock on, and it's automatic. And oh, when it's a race, the pigeons come inside. We can follow here on the TV what pigeon, what time, what meters make the pigeon. Everything we can follow on each TV. This racing loft. See, this is already cleaned. We make it every year like new.
And what do you use for cleaning? Dettol.
But also we do from upstairs.
Roof cleaning.
Everything. Everything. All the dust away. Every year. They are empty now. They are all together there on the young birds loft. But on 2 weeks, I put all the cocks and the hens back, and then we start there.
The positioning from the loft is south or
southwest. The position is when you see the pigeons come from there. So we are looking always from this side, and we have the most view, the biggest view. On this corner. This is the place to be for me. I'm sitting always here and I see very, very big. Like this. I do always like this. So I look to my pigeons.
Yes. Like God in France.
In heaven. In heaven.
The lady in heaven. Yes. A nice Belgian beer. And
when you pronounce the word beer, he's starting to laugh again.
Nice, very good.
With a beer, I think
yes,
it's even better.
For him as a businessman, it empties the mind.
Normally, is this the place for the young birds? But now it's everything is here, except the hens you see downstairs. These are my breeding cocks, my best ones, top pigeons. That is my Olympiade pigeon. It's an Olympiade pigeon. I breed by myself. I play by myself, and I never sell it. I only keep it. It's my best friend. It's a champ. Yeah, I don't let them anymore out. I'm scared to lose it, scared to...
And the children also good?
First time in breeding loft, is, I have young children now, they go to the Witwers loft last year. That is, for the moment, the best breeder I have. It's a new Eagle Eye. Eh? Wins by himself the first Provincial Cahors. It's around 800 kilometers. Eh? And it's a breeder of many winners. National winners, zone winners, provincial winners. It's a very, very good breeder. Yeah, yeah.
Eagle Eye.
Eagle Eye, yeah.
Can I have it?
You give me €5 and then you can take it.
Yeah, give
me more. No, back of Beyers is okay.
Oh, yeah.
Long distance, eh? Yeah.
800K and more.
Also breed by myself. Yeah, mostly it's from Eric Lamboer. It's the Eagle Eye line. It's one of the best breeding lines I ever had. And Albrecht Raoul Sablon, it's 801 of Albrecht. It's very good. I have a lot of Buck 17. I have also KBDB pigeons that I play.
Ace
that was Ace pigeons. That was from Verrekt Arjen. I can take that pigeon. It's one day pigeon.
Shablon for
many
long distance.
10
years ago.
That's
incredible.
Yeah. This is the first pigeon Pipa ranking, 5 races on the 1 day races, the number one. He is number 3 in the KBDB long distance, ace pigeon. Also, I breed it by myself. That is one of Verrekt Arjen strain. That's the name is Johan 275. Yeah. That's a very strong pigeon. It's 2 bags now, eh? I count.
Yeah. Come we go. Super pigeon.
Super. It's perfect, perfect.
This lot is the perfection.
This is a son of 801. Eh? It's father of first Provençal Brief, father of another bird, first Brief, first Limoges, father of the first, another, it's a hen then, and the other two are cocks. The daughter one win the first in the zone of Limoges this year. That's a very good breeder, a very hard pigeon. It's the Raoul Sablon, it's 801.
All the same.
2012.
Is a bit longer and the feathers are more thinner. This is really nice.
It's a nice cut of the feathers. Huh?
Yes.
Thank you.
Really, really great.
Both of them very good results with them. Yeah. I have other good cocks, cocks of other national winners inside father. Dus ja, I have also very nice sons of Johan already that I selected for breeding. You see, when you have a young bird like this, it's the son of Johan, the third national age pigeon. I don't say nothing anymore, just feel that pigeon.
Same.
That's quality, Another exceptional pigeon. First Provençal Narbonne. He was here on 4 hour and 45 minutes in the morning. The quarter by 5 was still dark and he arrived. He played the first Provençal Narbonne. Ja, Stefan.
Boom.
Yeah. That are all young birds for my best breeders. The old one of the young bird, and this is also young birds for breeding next year. I just keep them separated. They are 2 months later than the other one. Okay. And here we start with racing cocks. That is, these are the racing cocks for the long distance. We see here also my pigeons that this year win on Barcelona and on Perpignan here included. And the new young birds that I want to play next year as yearlings for the long distance. And these are the old birds that I race still with. I think 80% is first prize winner in this loft. These are racing hens for next year. I have a lot of racing hens, around 50, 60 hens, I think, for next year that we play. No, no, Witwer Shaft, but with. No, not complete. It is Witwer Shaft, more with one partner always home, always. I did it complete, more. It's not good. These are also hens and hens for racing. Then we go on the backside here.
And for Barcelona or on the nest? Or?
For hens, it's better on the nest. I think I have maybe two hens for next year on to play on the nest. But the widowers, I play mostly with widowers on the long distance. Then it's cocks. These are all pigeons, they are sold. That's as you see, they are sold to Pipa, this one. That's a brother of the Olympiade pigeon. He went also the first on Cahors, 800 kilometers. It's a full brother. That's the 6th National KBDB Ace Pigeon. It's also on Pipa. You can make a bet. Yeah, yeah, that can we do, yeah. Yeah,
probably 25, 30. Even more, I think. And the parents are also here.
No, no, no. That is from Albrecht. Son of Johan. It's 1,400 now on Pipa. Yeah. That's the daughter of that ice pigeon, but also a nice one. And these are all stock breeders. They are normally, I keep them for the Witwer hens or breeding for the feeders. Yeah, I have a lot. Pigeons that they are not good enough for me, I just keep them always. And there are also pigeons that are not fertilized anymore, but where I love them, because I keep them. There's also one Olympiade pigeon inside, it's special man. All cocks here that are hens for feeding, and then also cocks. Ah, yeah, they are in the. Yeah, you bring them, yeah. The divers got to bring it, of the. Ah, yeah, okay. Now you bring the pigeons back from the shower. Tot ze nog maar wat eten, hè? Tot ze maar eten. Hey, now they can have food and drink, and then they go upstairs. All feeding hens.
See, they like bears.
Yeah.
Is it prepared, Mark?
It's,
you did something on it?
No, 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 no.
Pure.
Pure Bayers. It's always good. Yeah, these are from the system here. We put it on, but it's not much on, I think, now. It's this morning cleaning. have a small story. I have a long time pigeons. My grandfather started with pigeons when I was I'm a 6 years old boy. He take me to his loft and he built a loft for 1 square meter. And he put there 4 pigeons in. That's the starting of my pigeon career. It's now I'm 52. 6 years I was starting. It's 44 years that I am starting with pigeons.
And you go from 1 square meter now to 1,000 square meters.
Well, around that, yeah.
But the passion is still
there. The passion is
and
still there.
The passion from your grandfather, he gave it to you? Or?
Yeah, like we tell, it's the Z, the microbe, what is
yes,
it?
The disease.
The diseases of the pigeons.
The virus.
The virus. When you have that one time in your blood, you cannot leave it. Eh? That's pigeons is...
You're addicted, it's in the genes.
By the way, this is André Monens. He's a very good friend of Mark also. Lives in the Brussels area.
Yes.
And so they have a long-time relationship.
We have a long-time relationship. I think almost 15 years. More than 15 years.
I was here from... the year 2000 until 2008,
yeah.
And I get back on my own to play myself.
And on that time we have also a nice story when he play for his own. One day he played the first national on Bourges,
yes.
The biggest race in Belgium for young birds. He wins us with his young birds. But on that day, the same day, I play also the first international Narbonne. With hen. Dus we are 2 national winners on one day, on the same day, for 2 friends. That is very nice.
He with your pigeon and you with his pigeon.
When we talk, when we talk about that, the hair of your arms gets up again.
Yeah, that's beautiful. So that's nice to hear.
That's nice to hear. Yeah, and I have all my life pigeons, and I always buy good pigeons. I have very hard in race, very hard in selection.
You do it continuously since you were 6, or you had some periods?
No. I never stopped. Oh. Every year, all the time. Yes.
And you continued with the strain from your grandfather? Is still in your body?
No. It's too long ago. I think I'm almost 40, 50 years. My grandfather is a long time dead already. Now. I have started first with the pigeons of my grandfather, then I start with Janssen's Arendonk pigeons, and then I bought everywhere the best one. But the most successful pigeons were the Raus Sablon pigeons and the pigeons of the line of Eagle Eye. They have the most breeding success with. Yeah.
And now you build all your colony on these birds?
On these birds and also the good birds that I by myself breed and I play very well, I don't sell it anymore. I just keep it. Just, I want to make that strain on my own strain and that I'm now doing now 3-4 years. The children of the good ones, I bring them also to the breeding and I breed with the children of that good bird, with the children with that good bird, I bring them together and that make my own strain very hard. And I have also a lot of results last year, this racing season, many players win first national, Gert Nuls, Jos Tonnet, Bart Basset, a lot of people win first national races. With my strain, and that is very happy.
It is time that we create the strain of Mark de Kock. I no longer make publicity for the other fences. Because if he's always telling with respect for these fences that he's successfully with pigeons of the Raus Sablon, Eric Lambourg, for the future, we should have to have the possibility to tell this is 100% strain Mark de Kock.
Yes,
I already hear it.
Yeah, you hear it many times. Many people win already.
It's logic that people create an own line, the Kock line, and other fanciers. Everybody goes for his strain. His idea of quality and result.
I think if you put something on your mind, then you will easily and for sure achieve. So. If that's your dream, Of course. Half of it, it's already there, of course. Yeah. Now you need the luck. You have everything. You have.
Yeah, only the luck you need on this place. I tell many times, it's only luck we need. Without luck, you cannot win a national race.
Yeah. Has all the cards in his hand, so accepted the luck.
The words that come up on my mind when I see everything, I put it on the main door there: quality, quality lofts, quality manager, quality birds, quality products, of course.
Yes. Quality feeding. Eh? I always start with one mark, and that is Beyers. I never change it. Before, I always used two or three different brands, but it's not of your from Beyers, eh? But the last 5 years, only I've used Beyers. And I see my results were very, very good. And I don't want to change anymore. People can give me for free feeding. I don't accept it.
Yeah, well, we are a bit the same as Mark, eh? So we go for the best. We try to find the best, which corn in our case, which is not always easy. We also, the climate situation, this year was too dry, last year was too wet, so or vice versa. This has effect on the corn.
So as you have some big challenges with the birds and everything, of course, Beyers on the same has the same problems, because we have to have the same price for the products, but we don't want to quit the quality, because when you have droughts in Europe, for example, then the price of the corn, it's so high, but you cannot eliminate the quality. You have to take it at that price quality, and to maintain it also as a low price for the pigeon fanciers. But quality, of course, we don't say it, we just go for it. We lose 1 year, but we want to maintain the quality, of course.
This is also here why each pigeon has a value. So they're all winners.
Yeah. Well, for me, you can only breed winners out winners.
Yeah.
That's only what I believe.
Do you have a special system, Mark?
For racing or for breeding?
Yes, for breeding, or you can also explain
how. Yeah, for racing, I have a special, like I think everybody, a race Whitworth system. Only with the hen is always home, or the cock is always home when I race with the hens. Eh? And I race almost every week. I try to race, but the long distance races are on 2 weeks.
All
2 weeks. Yes. What I try when I start to race, we go and we go each week. Then they are better and better. I see when the birds fly more and more.
They benefit.
They benefit, and they are starting to go better and better. Eh? Also for the hens, when you start with hens, you cannot stop to race anymore till the end of the season. Eh?
Yeah.
And you see the quality come always on top. You see the other birds stay away of the. They are not good enough anymore, they go out aloft, and I just, when I start with 100 birds, I end with 40 birds, but only the 40 best. And then the strong survivors.
This is maybe something for the people international, your advice. So start, but then do a big selection.
Yeah, what I some heard of many people, they know always that they are more clever than the birds, that they are, no, that's a good one, that's not a good one. I keep everything, 100 birds, play the 100 birds, and make the race, the decision, that's a good one or not. Race them each week. And you see sometime, I also see sometime, it's a bird that I don't like, but it's a good one. Because
the
I keep
result
it.
Is there.
Yeah, it's a winner. Because I keep it. I can show you my old birds too, that I don't like. I don't like it, but they are winners. Thus I keep them. But when I go select before, they are out.
Yeah.
Then the winners you don't have anymore.
So it's the result.
The result is only, it's the one only thing that is. And also what I do then for breeding, I see always when you have in your racing loft, 2, 3, 4, 5 of that strain, it's a strain that have good genes. Eh? That genes that I want to have put in my loft. And also of that father and mother, I keep nice birds that never raced, but it's good genes. I try to breed it and breed it in the loft with other good birds. Eh? And so I make my own strain.
Yeah. So people who have not too much place, or you say select hard.
Very hard, yes, very hard. But you must select when your bird is always healthy. Yeah? When they are not healthy, the selection is not good. But when you are sure that your birds are healthy, they are in good condition, have good results, you can fly many races, and they are still good, that bird you keep. And there you look what is the father and mother, there you can keep children out for breeding. That's the only way, the only right way.
And that's why, and this is my philosophy, that's why when you want to have a good bird, go and buy it directly for the, from the big fancier. Because the big fancier knows how to train her, to keep her healthy, how to select her, but properly, because I do strong selection, yeah? I bought one bird from Mark, for example. So, it's already a kinder. If I buy it small, you don't know what's in his head, right? After that, I make another bird out of it. Maybe I think, oh, I want to acclimatize it. And I don't want to risk that too. I keep that one too. So, we are already between third generation. But if I don't have the cleverness, the eye, to see if is it healthy, so I cannot select it, but I send it to a race sick, because it won't come back. And it might be a very good bird, but you lost it.
Yes, yes.
And a stupid one stays home, and after that you sell Marc de Kock at second or third hand birds. But the selection is not the same. That's why it's more expensive to come and take
that's
it, because...
That's why people come and buy it.
Exactly.
With Mark.
But they don't understand. Some of them, they just don't understand how important it is to make the things right to get, at the end, those 40 really good Spartans.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. How do you work in your breeding? Is it strongly inbred? Or is it
No. I do inbred, but not strongly. I try to have my own lines, a good lines of Eagle Eye with a good mixed line of the Rouse Sablon, of with a strain of my birds. Mm-hmm. I mix it together, the children that I try to mix it. Well, inbred I do sometimes, but not much.
Everybody does, I think.
That everybody want to do it. I don't do that.
And in the breeding, special products or something that you say, I like to do it this way, or you say, no, I just give them...
No. I give this the vitamin RLs from Bayer's, the grit every week. I change everything of grit. And I make a new grit with avid coral, some...
protein.
That I always make. And then in the water I give Herbazim. Always when I give it, it's minimum 3 days in a row. I don't give it 1 day.
Yeah.
Always 3 or 4 days, and then I change it with the tea product of some local oil, garlic inside. Also, I do sometimes for like vitamins. I do that on the water. Yeah, but always I give something in the water. 3-4 days
for the breeders.
For the breeders.
And the racing is the same. You do a build-up system or
It's always like this. Always. Also with vitamins, feeding, and the feeding season. The racing season, I have like you go like mountains up and down. That's when they are back from the race. I give like a super diet, and then when I go the last 4 or 5 days, I give only long distance. With some sunflowers with.
Peeled
sunflowers, yes. I give the last few days some pinda nuts like that.
Or do you have secrets? Every fancier has a small secret.
I know how to feed my pigeons.
Of course.
It's very important.
It's also important that they keep eating, probably.
That's
moment.
That's the specialization. It's very, very important to eat till the basketing. It's not easy,
You play the hands every week.
Every week.
But I know that your favorite distance is over 500-600.
It's between and 600 and 800.
They go every week at the same distance or up?
Sometimes I cannot do every week more than 600-700. Then they go sometimes on 300, and then they go again on 600-700, 300, 600, 500. 500 I can do every week, it's no problem.
What is your dream? the biggest dream or the future, the bloodline, you want to be a national champion or you want to win, I think each fan share has dreams.
Barcelona, when you can win Barcelona national internet, that is exceptional. But yeah, it's a long way. I start to very difficult. Yeah. Also, you need luck for Barcelona. You need always good pigeons. Without good pigeons, never go.
And disadvantaged, but, you need time also.
Well, what I want to play is each year an ace pigeon KBDB. It's very important. That is what I most like to do.
So people. If we don't follow. We are selected also.
Yeah, it is.
I'm usually to manage people. I see everything. I know what I want, and I can bring people the way what I want. I am very strong in that part.
You know what? It's easy. With him, it's easy.
Yeah.
He's the captain. There's only one captain.
Yeah, but that's
so. If you have a problem, and you tell, if I have a problem, I don't know anything. I say, Mark, please repeat it. Please tell me. You will never have one word, one bad word. I work with him for many years. We never had one bad word. Why? Because if there is, you have to know your place in the pyramid. Life is pyramid.
And he has this.
But there is also there is respect from both sides. There is respect from both sides. Respect, you have to earn it. If you earn the respect, you get respect. If you don't earn the respect, your place is no longer here.
And pigeon sport 20 years ago compared to pigeon sport now is totally different.
It's like bicycle racing. Eh?
Eddie
Merckx made 49 kilometers in 1 hour. Now they are going to make 60 kilometers within 5 years because they have materials to race we should tell there is a motor.
Everything depends. The competition is different.
But also the races. Are getting faster and faster. The result is now closing after half an hour for a race of 500 kilometers.
Finished.
National result is 30 minutes, 35 minutes. 20 years ago in Barcelona, we took a week to finish the result. Now we have the same day sometimes, a pigeon at home. The same day, it happened already.
No, it's happened,
And then some pigeons who are so near by their loft, that in the morning they are already there at 4:15, so then you can imagine that they are very close to their home.
Yeah.
We had here the night flyer.
Who came? They had it in hand.
No, it was another pigeon night flyer. It was 2 hours in the night, he come inside.
Yes.
It was the first year that was the automatic clock started, and we put it on. Everything we go sleep and we come in the morning.
Everything was eliminated.
And it's a pigeon. It's not, I let them see. You see, it's a pigeon. We go look on the loft. 2 o'clock. He was on 2 o'clock. He was in the loft. It was still dark.
And the same, that same pigeon. We were here on the bench waiting for the pigeon. It was on a race from Orange.
Orange.
And we were both looking, not asleep, not drinking, not nothing. And suddenly we heard beep, and we saw just a part of his tail.
Yeah,
as
going
fast
inside.
As he went inside.
Unbelievable. But you don't see him,
And really he was so fast and motivated, chick, and we heard beep, and we saw and just a part of his tail. Hmm. But I think he had in 31st national, or 14th national.
Yeah, it was very early.
On a very hard race. That was an exception.
Yeah, that was a very very nice part.
Yes, everything develops, and you are part of it. I can see some new systems that I've never seen before. So you come up with something new. Everything develops.
Yes, but of course this is Mark. Mark goes for the best. Searches the best for his pigeons. Not everybody can do that.
Innovative. So, bring something else. But I couldn't ever think about
it. On the other hand, it is somebody who searches, who tries, who tests, who... It's passion.
About your grandfather. And you said he was a hero.
Yeah, he was my voorbeeld, to say that.
His example.
He was my example in life.
His mentor.
Yeah, yeah. Also, he was passionate of pigeons. Eh? He was also the butcher man. Eh? He had a very bad wife. Eh?
Dominant wife.
Unbelievable. Yeah, yeah. And he always...
He was married. He couldn't.
Yeah, he was always talking with me on that. Eh? And when he was down and I was there, he was happy. We go to the loft. I was 6 years, on 6 hours in the morning. Every Saturday, Sunday, I was with him in the loft. In the week, I need to go to the school. When I was home, always I was with him. We go inside, we drink a coffee, we take something to eat, go back to the loft. He was a very specialist in short races. Eh? One time he go and he tell, I'm going to play with one pigeon. Eh? And he can double in that time 12 times. Eh? 12 times is the pigeon. You can compete 12 races with one pigeon, eh? Competitions. Eh? And you win the first prize 12 times with that pigeon. And only one pigeon. Eh? He was a specialized on short. He can motivate, and always with hands he play. Eh? On that time, all, eh? Yeah. Always with
and
hands.
In
yeah.
That period, there was a lot of money.
Yeah, yeah, yeah,
I'm talking about thousands of euros.
And Belgium money, Belgium yeah, money. And that time was a lot, yeah.
Because now there is no.
I think he, on that
there's
time.
No, anymore now,
no, but in that time he had, I think, 100. There's 2,500 euros. He win, or 100,000 Belgian francs. In that time,
ago, 40 years ago.
More than 40 years ago, eh?
It is now 50,000 euros.
No, it's amazing.
That time it's 2 months salary or 3 months salary that he won. Eh?
You know,
and also one time we walk in the company from the meet. It was a small company. And he take me up and he put me on some pallets. Eh? And say, I want that you make my company one of the biggest of Belgium. And I never forget that. And I did it for him.
Motivated you.
And motivated always.
You saw him
I promised him and I do it for him. And always think on that side. Always. Now, that's the reason he is my hero. He is always with me. Yeah. I'm also the only person that have the card more than 40 years when he was died. I can show you it. It's in my car. It's always with me. Always. Yeah. Nobody can show it, I'm sure. But it's more than 40 years dead. Yeah.
This is respect.
Yeah, that was his name. That's his name. It's Charles de Kock. That's his name.
That's why I told you, if you earn the respect of him, you got the respect. Yeah. How small you may be in the society, eh? Even the guys who are cleaning here, they got the respect that they earn.
Yeah, Mark, but if I understand it well, your grandfather was the sprint specialist.
Yes.
And then you told in the interview you started with Bijn Janssens, so you were actually also in the... In the speed?
We start in the speed,
and then we built up.
Yeah, I play with my father, then middle distance, many times, many years, middle distance, and then we go farther and farther.